Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Vishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. I believe you all are okay. So today we are going to discuss a multiple choice question about multiple step organic transformation. Okay, such kind of multiple choice question could be useful for the exams like BSMS, BSc, MSc, CSIR, NEET, GATE, IIT, JAM, etc. exams. So as usual, I first request you student, please read the question carefully. And after that, pause the lecture and try by yourself. See, the question is given in front of you and four options are provided in front of you and one of them is the right answer. So I request you, please try by yourself. I hope you have tried by yourself. So right now I shall explain what is the actual answer of this problem. For that purpose, so generally what I do, I generally give you the answer, but in this case, for multiple step transfer, I shall not give you right now answer. I'll do step by step transformation, and at the end, I shall explain how to solve such question less than 30 seconds. I believe that's very important for your examination point of view. So let's go. So when such kind of questions are given, first of all, you don't need to be panic. You try to understand what functional group is given in front of you and what reagents are given, what's their property. See, by nature, this is actually a allylic alcohol. Okay, so just allylic alcohol. And see, this is diethyl tartarate. It also conceived abbreviated as DET. But look at carefully, I haven't mentioned plus or minus, just diethyl tartarate. And titanium isopropoxide and tertiary butyl hydroperoxide. What is this condition? This is sharpless asymmetric epoxidation. Okay, so I have already discussed a dedicated lecture on surface asymmetric epoxidation as well as dry hydroxylation. So please visit if you have any doubt. So what it will result? So first step, sharpless oxidation or epoxidation, whatever. So it will result this. Since no stereochemistry is mentioned, I shall not bother in stereochemistry. And by the way, look at, no options are given about mentioned stereochemistry. So don't need to be worried about this problem, is easier. Now next step, COCl, DMSO, DCM, trithylamine, and second one. What is this? This is nothing but Swern oxidation. I shall very soon upload a dedicated lecture on Swern oxidation. So you can study from there. So what it result? It selectively oxidizes alcohol into aldehyde. I am not going to any mechanism of any step. Please visit dedicated lecture for mechanism. So actually this part will be oxidized. So what it will result? These epoxide are prime. This is double bond. No, this is aldehyde. By the way, you can ask, sir, during this reaction condition, will the aldehyde survive? This epoxide survive? Because it will survive. Why? We know the epoxides are mainly stable in alkaline medium, but unstable in acidic medium. In this case, due to reaction with COCl, some HCl will produce, which will be quenched by this trithylamine. So medium cannot be acidic. It could be neutral or slightly alkaline. So stable. Second, for epoxide opening under alkaline condition, we need a nucleophile. In this case, what it will produce? It will produce chloride as a nucleophile, and trithylamine is not a good nucleophile. It is a specific proton scavenger or base. And by the way, I have already discussed about epoxide opening under acidic, basic and neutral medium. Please visit if you have any doubt on this epoxide chemistry. Fine. So it will not open, and DMSO is not that much good nucleophile. So epoxide opening is not possible under these reaction conditions. It will not open. Fine. In the next step, what is given? See, in the next step given RLI in anhydrous THF, then what? So question, two reaction possible. RLI can open this epoxide or attack this carbonyl. First of all, you need to think which center is more electrophilic, electron deficient. Obviously the aldehyde, because it has a canonical form, this C plus O minus is highly electron deficient compared to the epoxide. Because in this case, just think, one oxygen is attached to one carbon for aldehyde. In this case, one oxygen attached to two carbon.
So in which one is more electron deficient? Obviously, this oxygen is not that much satisfied how much it needed. So it will increase the positive charge density or electrophilicity more at this position. Second, we know that nucleophilic addition is a reversible reaction, and this phenomenon is governed by the Barby-Lunich trajectory. I have discussed in dedicated lecture. Please visit if you don't know the concept. So actually, Barby-Lunich trajectory, this is a concept, governs how the nucleophile will attack the carbonyl carbon. In this way, see, this is actually an aldehyde. So attack of the nucleophile is not that much difficult. Why? Because it is aldehyde. This hydrogen is very small. So steric repulsion is minimized in case of aldehyde compared to ketone. So reaction will happen. And one thing remember, this alkyl lithium, if you want to show how this alkyl lithium reacts, please remember this chemistry. Alkyl lithium transfer via four member ring. What do I mean? These lithium coordinates here and attached to this R means this minus. Sorry, in this case R double prime. So in this way it this. Okay, so what it results? It results CO, this is R double prime, O minus Li plus. After workup, this O minus Li plus will hydrolyze and produce alcohol. Okay, so aldehyde will, what will be the fate of this aldehyde? Aldehyde will be converted into a secondary alcohol. So, sorry, this is actually this COCl such that you do not get considered. Okay, this SOARN oxidation, and this is R double prime Li, and then what? Fine, so this is minus, this is plus. So what it will result? It will result this, let me save some space. This is R, this is R prime, double, this is epoxide, this is a, sorry, secondary alcohol after work. This and this is R double prime. Fine. Is it visible? Yes, it is visible. Now, in the last step, see, last step is again SOARN oxidation. Means same step I have given, so you don't need to be worried. So what is this? Aldehyde in last step will be converted into the corresponding this. Oxidation means this alcohol will be converted into carbonyl group, and since it's a secondary alcohol, it will be converted into ketone. And SOARN oxidation is a selective oxidation. And again, why epoxide will survive, just I have explained previously, so no need to be worried about. So answer of the problem is this one. Okay, now question. If this question is provided in your exam within less than 30 seconds, how can you solve the question? And this thing, you have to know the reagents and reaction conditions and reactivity or nature of the molecule. This is the allylic alcohol, and you have given this condition, means surplus asymmetric epoxidation. But since no asymmetry is mentioned in the product, forget about it. It's easier. So it is an epoxide. Second, it's a SOARN oxidation. So SOARN oxidation will oxidize alcohol to corresponding carbonyl. By the way, question, will epoxide survive? Obviously survive, because medium is slightly alkaline, or you can say neutral. So it will not open up. Now this thing. So in this way we get the carbonyl, and carbonyl reaction with RLI. What happens? Obviously secondary alcohol addition reaction. Nucleophilic addition, and after that due to oxidation, this is. Now, as I told, if you have studied very much properly, and another thing, you can do it very fast in the exam hall. Within 30 seconds, you can end up with this answer. Otherwise, what could be the tricks? So, first of all, this step is completely logical strategy. And second, this right now what I am going to say is a trick. How can you eliminate non-valid option? So this is actually process of elimination. Now, question. First step, you have to remember what is the product. In first step, this is the product. You must be completely aware of the fact. Now, use your idea. So, SOARN oxidation, whatever this thing, what can happen? Alcohol will be oxidized, fine. RLI will be added to ketone. Okay. By the way. See, SOARN oxidation cannot open up this epoxide ring. So what can you expect? This epoxide ring broken, this and this gone. Because under this condition, epoxide will not be open. Second, now question whether this or this. By the way, RLI is given, a very common sense. If it is useless, then why it is mentioned? So you can nullify these and this.
Or if you want to go slight more logical way, see, oxidation of carbonyl, where the nucleophilic addition possible, either carbonyl or epoxide? Obviously, because this is not only carbonyl, this is aldehyde. So, this is the answer. Addition, and second step is again oxidation. So, this, but not this. So, this is a process of elimination, but in order to utilize this strategy, first of all, your knowledge need to be good and you need to do enough practice. And during the exam hall, you need to keep your mind cool, such that this process of elimination can benefit you. Okay, so this is the end of this discussion. What we have learned today? We have learned today about multi-state reaction and how we can solve the questions within a very short time using our understanding about the reagents in organic chemistry and organic transformation and basic concept in organic chemistry. So this is the overall discussion. Thanks for watching. If you really like my teaching, I request you please support my channel, subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon such that you get notified when I upload a single new video. And most importantly, please like the video and share this video among your friends such that they get the benefit of my effort. And most importantly, if possible, please support my channel through Patreon. Okay, so thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video.